for a little ride, Duke, but not to the courthouse.
Buddy, it's Frisco. Sit down.
Frisco.
It's okay, we have to stand here for just a few minutes.
What are you guys doing? I don't understand. Just taking your handcuffs off right now. Sean's in on this, too. He just took out Burns and Kowalski, but he had to get to the courtroom.
How did you raise it? The timing was so off.
Well, we were a little early.
I'm always early.
I hate that part when women are early. Don't you hate that when women are always early?
No, this time I don't hate it. Hey, but I never thought Robert and Anna would ask you to help me. I thought you guys hated me.
You saved our lives.
Listen, you're a strange man to figure out, but we do owe you.
Another thing I don't understand, I thought you were co-pater.
Well, let's get into that later, okay? Right now, we have to get you someplace safe.
That's right, we have to change our clothes and get to the courthouse before Ramsey realized you escaped.
I'm gonna drop this van off in an alley. There's a car waiting there for you. You can get away that way. I got some clothes in the van. We can change back here.
And I've got your sunglasses and an ID just in case you need it, the Sean made up special, and car keys.
Where am I gonna go? Is that being decided yet?
Yeah, Anna said the cottage. She said you'd know where that was.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I do. Our cottage.
You still love her a lot, don't you?
Yeah. Yeah, she's in my blood, but I realize that where I'm concerned, it's over.
I'm sorry.
Yeah, it's okay. I mean, I didn't deserve her love in the first place.
No, don't say that.
All we have left is the truth now. Here, buddy. Okay. Thank you.
Anna, how's it going?
Fine, just fine.
Bert's still watching us.
No, he's talking to friends. It's all right.
Duke got safely away with Frisco and Felicia, but let's not look too happy about the news, huh?
It's very interesting news, isn't it, Robert?
Yeah, very, insofar as that our friend changed the time schedule. Oh, I know all about that. Well, thank God for Felicia. It seems one of her big problems in life is that she always likes to get the parties first. If we'd been a few seconds late, they would have had Duke.
Is he all right?
He's a little shaken up from the close call, but otherwise he's fine. Well, safe. Obviously, Bert hasn't heard the news yet. He's coming over. Let's play the game.
Well. Hey, this is quite a sight.
A sight, Chief?
Yeah, three ex-WSB agents together.
Oh, that? Oh.
You know, it makes an old cop like me really stand in awe of you three.
Well, you shouldn't be back.
Oh, come on, Anna. Your intelligence, your background, your training. A flat foot like me, I kind of feel out of place. But I must say, poor Charles is darn lucky to have people like yourselves looking after its welfare and interests.
Come on, Bert, you're spreading it a bit thick, aren't you?
Oh, I'm sorry, Robert. I'm sorry, but that's really the way I feel. I know that you always tried to make me feel like you're equal.
Chief?
The van here?
Yeah, no, I don't know about that, but there is a reporter here from National Magazine who'd like to interview you.
All of a sudden, I become a celebrity. But where is he?
He's right back here. I'll take you to him.
Oh, okay.
You deserve every minute of your
bath. Thanks, Anna. That's very nice of you. You know, it's very rare that an old, tired cop like me gets all this attention. See you later. Come on.
Okay, Bert. Here we go.
Yeah, it's okay.
Don't you
know, I never realized in all these years that Bert hated me all this much.
It's just sad, buddy. Just sad.
Where's Tiffany?
Didn't
I heard one of her crew say she was chasing down the DA.
Chief, Duke Lavery's escaped.
What?
I just got a call from headquarters. They found the van abandoned in an alley. It was empty.
Can't believe it.
I put out an APB on Duke.
Good.
Wait a minute. What about the guards?
Oh, they haven't located either one of them yet. I sure don't look forward to telling this to Chief Ramsey. Excuse me.
Everything's working.
Yes.
It's important that Frisco and Felicia get here, and very, very quickly.
Oh, Burke is getting the news.
He got it. No. He just got it.
Listen, will you put on an APB? We've got to get Mike. Will you people excuse us, please? Listen, we'll tell you something. We've got to get this going and getting going fast.
Yes.
Lewis, I want roadblocks set up. Stop every car.
I'll get right on it.
And I want the officers that were driving the police van to be found, too.
We've got to find out who Lavery's accomplices are.
Burns and Kowalski still haven't been located.
Okay. Sean, what happened? I heard something's up.
Duke Lavery escaped.
Oh, come on, Rick. Yeah, let's start the camera turning, okay?
What is this that I hear about Duke Lavery escaping?
It's true, but we don't have any details yet.
I mean, how could this happen? What is going on with the Port Charles police?
Chuck, what's all the excitement?
Duke escaped.
What?
What is this about my boss escaping?
We don't have time to answer your questions now, Frisco.
And it's true?
Yes, it's true, and I've got work to do. Now, turn off that camera, please.
Not when it's news, Chief Ramsey.
It's a good thing it's in color, Tiffany. You can get a perfect shot of the bright red faces of the Port Charles Police Department.
That's enough out of you.
The police ought to be ashamed of themselves.
Come on. Just what is the Port Charles Police Department going to do about this?
I'll tell you what we're going to do. Is that camera on?
Absolutely.
Yes, it is, Bud.
All right, listen to me, everybody. And this includes you, too, Duke Lavery, and your accomplices. There's no way that you can stay hidden from me, Lavery. I'll move heaven and earth to get you back here, and I'll do it. That's a promise, folks. One other thing. My men will have orders to shoot to kill.